So let's go jump into today's class. I'll just finish in 42 minutes. There are only six functions. Okay, first let's discuss the global functions. Okay, so there are three global functions. These global functions are used to convert So now, sometimes in programming, okay, I'll just write here. I'll explain when we use this first. So global objects. All right. So sometimes what happens is your server, or let's say there's an AJAX request. AJAX request keeps on AJAX request. Okay, we'll talk about this later. But yeah, sometimes this request will send data to JavaScript. Like we call AJAX request via JavaScript. Okay, so that data will always be a string. Okay, this data will always be a string. Or let's take our form data. When accessed by our JavaScript, it is always a string. Okay, so it means like whenever a data is coming to JavaScript, it's always in a string format. So to change that, sometimes what happens, you know, you see these calculators, online calculators, they do calculations via JavaScript. So they take the form input and they have to convert it into number so that they can process the data or they can do some operations over there. So to do that, we have to put the number, sorry, the string to number. Okay, so there are instances where we have to convert the information to number. So those operations or those actions are done by our global objects. So type of global objects we have here are parse int. Okay, this converts a number string. So why I'm calling it to be a number string? Because it should have a number in it. Like it cannot convert a string into a number. Like say, like name equal to dos live. If I say parse in dos live, it does not convert because there is no number in it. But if I say 20 apples and I want to have only dot of it, we'll see an example. Okay, this converts a number string to integer. Though we do not have integers in JavaScript, so integer here means only the real part, like, you know, it cuts off the decimal part and gives the real part. We have parse float. Okay, here we'll give that number string here also, number string. So what this does is this converts a number string to float. Okay, so these two are functions which are used to convert our number strings into floats and integers. So now let's go ahead and start writing a program. Okay, so any questions here? Parse int and parse float. Okay, and we'll see some real time example when we go into our events and DOM model. When we go to DOM model, yeah, then in DOM model we take this input from forms and just operate on it. Okay, let's go ahead and see. So here is our todos live. So a new file. Doc type HTML head title as usual, or title is tutors.lib.js. You call global objects. And here's our script. And here I'll write a function as usual to print function print. So the parameter is str. Here document dot write str plus PR. Alright, so let us say this, and this is on our desktop. Tutors live, the name is js global.html. Alright. So let's just start. So now my number string, or I'll take an array, okay, let's say var named string, sorry, array equal to new array, let's say. So here I'll give or just insert, I'll give I'll give 10, 12, here 13.20, and here 14 students, and here tutors live, and here I am one and only. Alright. So this is my array. It's a numbers array, like, you know, there are it's a combination of numbers and strings. That's what I said, number string array. Now here what I do is, like, I'll take the length. So var length equal to number string array dot length. If you guys can remember, dot length is used to the spelling sound here. Alright, now here I'll say var I equal to 0, I less than length, right, I plus plus. So here now what I want to do is, like, I want to print the type of and the value also. Okay, let's see. Print. So type of, let's say type of number string of that element plus, I'll give a gap here, then I want to see parse int, okay, of, let's say, the same. Or I'll say, let's take one more variable here, element. Okay, element is this. Why do we write so many times? So here I'll say element.